Hello, beautiful person watching. Welcome to the channel. This is Benna, and today we are making some delicious air fryer shrimp spring rolls. These spring rolls are so crunchy on the outside and juicy on the inside, loaded with vegetables. And the one good thing about them is that they come without the guilt. They are air fried rather than deep fried, which really cuts down the amount of calories. Now, we love them. My kids really enjoy them. Enough said, guys. Come on in and let's get started. So for our list of ingredients, we will need the following. Our cabbage. I have gone ahead and thinly sliced my cabbage as well as my carrots. I also grated them. You can go ahead and buy the store-bought coleslaw, which is a mixture of cabbage and carrots. You just want to make sure that they are thinly sliced. I have here my spring roll pastry. I bought this one in store. Salt and pepper. I have some sesame oil, my soy sauce. I have some, and it's low sodium soy sauce. I have my scallions or spring onions. I've gone ahead and chopped them up as well. I have some garlic cloves. I'm going to be mincing them. And of course, our shrimp. Now, when it comes to the filling, you can use ground chicken, ground turkey, ground pork. It really depends on you. So let's get started. So we are going to start by first of all cooking up our shrimp. I'm going to cook it for about 1 to 2 minutes. Now when it comes to cooking up your shrimp, you don't want to overcook it because then it can become rubbery. I'm only going to use salt and black pepper to taste, as well as the minced garlic. I'll first of all start by adding in my salt and black pepper. And once I'm about to turn off the heat, I'll add the garlic because I don't want to overcook it. I want the flavor of the garlic to be felt in the spring rolls once they are air fried. Now, once this is all done, I'll transfer our shrimp into a bowl and then we'll move on to the next step. Once our shrimp has cooled down a little bit, now it's time for us to marry the rest of the ingredients together. So I'm going to first of all start by adding our shrimp to the cabbage. Next I'll proceed to add our carrots, and I'll follow with our scallions, sesame oil, the soy sauce, and I'm going to make sure that I mix this properly. You want to make sure that you mix properly so everything combines. As well, want to make sure that your salt and pepper, they taste to your desired taste buds, because everyone is different. I did taste this and I added a little bit of salt as well. So just make sure that you adjust it to suit your taste buds. Once this is combined properly, I have also gone ahead and just sprayed a little bit of olive oil on the air fryer basket, and I'll start rolling up the rolls to put in there and start air frying. Now comes the fun part, to start rolling up our spring rolls. Now there's so many ways to do this. This is just the method that I'm more comfortable with. So please make sure you do you when it comes to rolling it over. I'm going to be using some water that I'll just dip in my brush and just brush the tips of the pastry. This is going to allow it to fold and seal properly so it doesn't open up in the air fryer once we are air frying it. As well, I'm using about 2.5 tablespoons of the filling. It really depends on what type of pastry you're using. If you're using spring rolls or you're using the egg roll, it depends. And as well, if you find that it is too light, maybe you want to double up the pastry. It just depends on you. But for me, I'm just using one. I'm okay with just one of them. Now, once this is all done, I'm going to spray some olive oil on it before I put it in my air fryer. And I'm going to air fry them at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 8 minutes. And I'll check halfway and flip it over. So please just watch as I complete this. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed watching this video today with me, guys. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to my channel if you already haven't done so. And when you do subscribe, do not forget to turn on that notification bell so each time I upload a new video, you'll be notified. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you get to try this recipe soon. Until I come your way next time with something healthy and delicious, please continue to drink lots of water, stay hydrated, be well, be safe. Thank you. Bye.